Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
In the last class, we had started with the play, The Merchant of Venice, and we did Act 1, Scene 1, and we could not finish the whole of it. We did the first part of the scene, and today we are going to do the last part of it, of Act 1, Scene 1, and then we will move to the next scene. To recapitulate the last part, what we did was Antonio was talking about himself. He said that he has come on the earth to play the sad part. It seems that the world is just like a stage where actors come to perform. Similarly, the character which he is playing, which Antonio is playing, is that of the sad one. That means that he constantly holds on to that sad, monotonous character of himself. Now, what did Graciano reply? Graciano said, "Let me play the fool," which means fool does not mean a normal stupid person. It means a comedian, okay, somebody who plays the comic role. With mirth and laughter, let old wrinkles come. So what did Graciano say? Graciano says that he does not want to spend a life so sad and monotonous, okay, there would be no fun in it always. He has to look so sad and depressed. He does not want to spend a life like that. How does he want to spend his life? He wants to spend his life with mirth. Mirth means, the meanings are also given over here, but mirth means with a lot of amusement, okay, with entertainments and everything. And laughter. So laughter means that he wants to enjoy his life a lot. He wants to live a life with a lot of happiness, entertainment, amusement, okay. Let old wrinkles come. See, when we talk about an old person, I think you have noticed that old people have wrinkles on their faces, beside their eyes, on their face, everywhere there are wrinkles. So he says that although he turns old and he gets a lot of wrinkles on his face, he likes to spend his life, enjoy his life to the utmost. He wants to drink wine and then go to the restaurants, enjoy his life to the utmost. And let my liver rather heat with wine. Now, you know that Shakespeare wrote in the period of Elizabeth, Queen Elizabeth. It is the Elizabethan period. So, in the Elizabethan period, there was a belief. The belief is written in green. See, Elizabethan belief. What was that belief? The belief was that when you drink a lot, it heats up your liver. You know, there is an organ called liver in your body. So, they believed, the Elizabethan people believed, that when you drink a lot of liquor, that means hard drinks, that is wine and all that, then what happens is it heats up your liver. That was a belief. So he says that I want to waste my liver, I want to heat my liver up, which means that he wants to drink a lot all his life. He wants to enjoy and amuse himself. Then my heart cool with mortifying groans, which means mortifying means shameful and painful groans. Instead of always looking sad and depressed like Antonio, he wishes to enjoy his life. He wishes to drink, go to pubs and live life to the fullest. Why should a man whose blood is warm within, which means blood is warm when you are younger. As you grow old, you will see that slowly your blood seems to be less warmer. Okay, it means that you lack that vigor which you have, that energy which you have in the younger days. When you are young, you will have a lot of energy. Okay, when you grow old, you will become slower in pace, isn't it? So your blood is warm, you always like to enjoy. When you are young, you always want to enjoy, but your parents or maybe the grandfathers and grandmothers, when they become old, they seem to lack so much energy. Okay, so Graciano thinks that it is so unnatural, it is so shameful, that why, when you are young, you are given to enjoy, you have so much energy. Why will you waste your time being so sad and depressed? You can enjoy like a young man. Sit like his grandsire. Grandsire means grandfather. When you are young, you don't need to sit like a grandfather cut in alabaster. Alabaster means this one. Alabaster means in pure white statue. You don't have to be like a old statue. You don't have to be like a statue of a grandfather. Why statue? Because statues don't move, isn't it? They are so still, they do not move, they don't make any movement, they do not enjoy. Okay, why do you have to sit like an old man, like a statue, when you are young? So Graciano does not understand Antonio's behavior at all. Next, sleep when he wakes, be motionless. So he goes on explaining that you are young, so you don't have to sleep and waste your time. Sleep means when he wakes. That means you are so motionless, you do not have that vigor, you seem not to have that energy that a young person have. It seems that when somebody looks at Antonio, they will feel that this person has become so old, this person cannot even, you know, we cannot distinguish whether this person is sleeping or whether this person is awake, because he does not make any movement, he is completely still. And creep into the jaundice by being peevish. So I don't want to waste my time, I don't want to be irritable, and I don't want to be, you know, all be diseased and like an old person sitting and doing nothing, just like Antonio. I tell thee what, thee means I tell you what, Antonio, so he is telling something to Antonio. I love thee, that means I love you, Antonio, and it is my love that speaks. So out of love only, because I love you, Antonio, because you are my dear friend, I want to give you some advice. What is that advice? There are a sort of men whose visages means facial expression. So he says that there are few people whose facial expressions are something like a standing pond, cream and mantle like a standing pond. Let's see this picture. When you stand beside a pond, when, like this girl, she's standing beside a pond, you see no ripples in the pond, isn't it? If there is no air, if there is no stone dropped into the pond, this pond will not have waves like the ocean, isn't it? If you go to Puri Digha, you will see waves. If you stand beside a pond, you will not see any movement on the pond. So these people, like Antonio, behave like a pond, like a standing pond. That means as still as a pond, make no movement at all. Okay, and do a willful stillness. Willful means obviously you are deliberately, that is your choice. By choice you are keeping quiet. Deliberate stillness, deliberate silence that you have. Entertain with purpose. Now, what, according to Graciano, what is the reason? Why is Antonio so still? Why is Antonio so serious and depressed? Why doesn't Antonio speak much? What is the reason? With purpose, to be dressed in an opinion. Dressed in an opinion means, according to Graciano, Antonio tries to look serious, sad, depressed because he wants to maintain a reputation. He wants to hold on to a reputation. What kind of reputation? Of wisdom, gravity, profound conceit. Profound conceit means deep thought. So according to Graciano, Antonio wants other people to think that he is very intelligent, he is wise, he is thinking deeply, he is an intellectual person. Okay, he wants other people to think this. As who should say, I am Sir Oracle. What is an oracle? Oracle is a person who is a priest who speaks the words of God. Okay, when priest gives an advice or something, it is taken that it is the advice of God, and priest is the spokesperson of God. So it seems that these people want people to think, Antonio, people like Antonio, want other people to think that they are as wise as these priests. Okay. And when I open my lips, let no dog bark. They also wish that when I keep quiet, people will think me that I am intellectual, I'm wise, I am so much intelligent, I have a lot of gravity. But when I will start speaking, let no dog bark. What does this mean? Let nobody speak. I will be speaking so well. I will be speaking so wisely that there would be pin drop silence. Everybody would be listening to me, just like they listen to the priest. Okay. Oh my Antonio, I do know of these that therefore only are reputed wise. So they are not really wise. What do you mean by reputed wise? They have a reputation. People think that Antonio and people like him are wise, but actually they are not wise. For example, if I keep quiet, if I don't tell you things about Merchant of Venice, then you will never understand whether I know anything or not. Unless and until I speak, until I tell you something about this play or anything, you will not know whether I am wise or whether I know anything or I don't know anything. You will not know. So if I just be quiet and tell you, okay, write down your answers, and I don't speak anything, I don't tell you answers, okay, then you will not know whether I am wise or not, isn't it? Or whether I am knowledgeable or not. So it is better to keep quiet. If you keep your mouth shut, then people might think that you are wise. For saying nothing when I am very sure, if they should speak, would almost damn those ears which hearing them would call their brothers fools. What does this mean? These people like Antonio, who keep quiet and want other people to think that they are wise, if they start speaking, then what will happen? Everybody will come to know that these people are very stupid, they are not at all wise, they are not at all intelligent. That is the reason why they don't speak. Okay. I will tell thee more of this another time. So Graciano has not finished yet. He says that, okay, I will tell you all about all these things, about the behavior of people sometime later. But fish not with this melancholy bait. Melancholy bait means the sad bait. You know, bait, it is given to catch a fish with a line. Okay. So he says that don't try to fish with this kind of a bait. People can understand it well, that because you are stupid, you are not speaking. Okay. For this fool gudgeon, gudgeon means the worthless fish, this opinion. So it is a worthless bait. Okay. This is a worthless idea that if you keep quiet, people will think you wise. We already know what you are. Clear? Come good Lorenzo, fare ye well a while. So fare ye well means goodbye. I will end my exhortation. Exhortation means all this good advice, the lecture that I am giving. I will end my lecture after dinner. After I finish my dinner, I will finish off with this lecture. So he hasn't yet finished. He has spoken a lot and has not yet finished. Lorenzo, well, we will leave you then till dinner time. So Lorenzo says, okay then, goodbye till dinner time. I must be one of these same dumb wise men, for Graciano never lets me speak. Now see, Graciano has a reputation that Graciano speaks a lot. Okay, he's always speaking and never letting other people speak. For example, if you are two friends and one of your friend goes on speaking, you never get time to speak. Then obviously you will become somebody like Antonio, who does not speak. And people will think that you are trying to hold on to that reputation, isn't it? You will appear dumb wise because you cannot speak, because the other person never gives you a chance to speak. Okay. Graciano, well, keep me company but 2 years more. So be my friend for 2 more years. Then what will happen? Thou means you. Shalt means shall not know. Thou shalt not know. That means you shall not know. The sound of thine, thine means own, thine means your own tongue. So it means that Graciano says, if you remain friend to me for 2 more years, then you will soon forget your own tongue, your own voice, because you will never get a chance to speak. I will go on speaking. Antonio, farewell, I will grow a talker for this year. So Antonio says that, okay, I have heard your advice. I think I will start speaking instead of keeping quiet and trying to make other people feel that I am very wise. Graciano, thanks in faith, for silence is only commendable. Commendable means it is suitable. According to Graciano, people should be silent only in a neat's tongue dried and a maid not bendable. So an old woman should keep quiet, and a tongue, it is a dish, kind of a dish, kind of a preparation, only ox's tongue. And old women should keep quiet. Otherwise, it is not necessary that you should keep quiet and prove something to others. Exeunt means exit. Graciano and Lorenzo, so they go away. Antonio, is that anything now? Is he right? That means, is that anything now means, is he right? That means Antonio asks Bassanio, do you think whatever Graciano says about me is correct? Bassanio, Graciano speaks an infinite deal of nothing. Infinite means a huge amount of nothing. So Graciano speaks a lot, more than any man in all Venice. Graciano speaks so much that it seems that he speaks more than all the people in Venice. Okay. His reasons are as 2 grains of wheat hid in 2 bushels of chaff. So you know this is chaff. This is all the leftovers when you have collected your rice grains and everything. This is that. And if you have a needle in it, it will be lost, isn't it? You cannot find it. So what Graciano speaks is quite like finding a needle inside this chaff. That means Graciano speaks a lot of things, but actually the meaning of it, the main idea of it, is just like a small needle. It is nothing. That means, what do you understand by this? That Graciano speaks a lot, but it is all worthless. You shall seek all day. Seek means you shall find all day. Air means before you find them. That means you go on searching this shaft to find what is the meaning of Graciano's words. You go on searching, 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 and when you have them, ultimately when you find them, okay, that what actually Graciano was trying to say, when you finally understand his words, they are not worth the search. That then you realize that it was not even worth searching for. Okay, it was just worthless. Graciano's words, trying to understand what Graciano is trying to say, is all worthless. Okay, now, Antonio. Well, tell me now, what lady is the same to whom you swore a secret pilgrimage that you today promised to tell me of? So Antonio asks Bassanio that, tell me now of that lady. You told me previously that you want to tell me something about the lady to whom you swore a secret pilgrimage. That means you secretly wanted to go to her place, go to the place where she lived. That you today promised to tell me of. You wanted to tell me about that lady. So please tell me, who is she? Bassanio. It is not unknown to you, Bassanio says, that see, you know everything about me, Antonio. Because Antonio and Bassanio are very good friends, so they know everything about each other. How much I have disabled mine estate. First thing that I want to tell you is, Bassanio is a spendthrift. He always spends, goes on, he's a prodigal. Prodigal means an extravagant person, always spending his money. If your mother gives you 10 rupees, you go and take a packet of chips from the shop and have it. So you are extravagant, you finish off your money immediately. So Bassanio is something like that. Whenever he has money, he spends it all. Okay. So see, how much I have disabled mine estate. So my financial situation is very poor. Okay, I don't have much money. By something... How now he goes on saying that, how did he waste his money? By something showing a more swelling port. Swelling port means I am living in a very grand style, but I don't have money. I am living in a luxurious way, but I do not have money to pay for it. Now, because I don't have money, but I want to live extravagantly, although I do not have money, I want to install an AC in my house, a washing machine in my house, 32 inches TV in my house, LED TV in my house, then how will I have all the money to buy these? I will have to borrow. Now, he has borrowed a lot of money here and there. So, his condition is very, very poor. Then my faint means would grant continuance. That means, my faint means, that is what money I have, that does not permit, or a countenance continuance means, it does not permit me to buy all these things or to spend so much money. But, nor do I now make moan. I do not complain to be abridged. Abridged means obviously I have to give these things up. I have to stop spending. Otherwise, my debts, D-E-B-T-S, are increasing and increasing and increasing, and I don't know how to pay them off. From such a noble rate, but my chief care is to come fairly off from the great debts. I have a huge amount of debts and it is going on increasing. I don't know how to pay off these great debts. There is so much of debt that I am indebted to that I don't know how to pay them. Wherein in my time something too prodigal hath left me gaged. So I am so extravagant in nature. Prodigal means extravagant in nature, that I am totally in debt. I don't know how to pay them. To you, Antonio, and obviously Bassanio has, you already know that Antonio is quite rich, and Bassanio has taken a lot of money from him also. So to you, Antonio, I owe the most. So the maximum debt I have is towards you, in money and in love. So both in love also I am indebted to you, in money also I have a lot to pay you back. And that means he has borrowed a lot of money from Antonio. To unburden, that means to, sorry, and from your love, because you love me dearly, because you are my dear friend, I have a warranty, which means I have an assurance that I can obviously unburden my plots, which means I have an assurance that I obviously can share my problems, my plans, my programs with you, and purposes how to get clear of all the debts I owe. So he says that, see, I have a plan. I want to clear off my debts. whatever I have borrowed, I want to pay the money back. I have a plan for it, and I want to share that plan with you. Antonio, I pray you, good Bassanio, let me know it. So Antonio says, good Bassanio, tell me what is your plan. And if it stand, that means if the plan is, as you yourself still do, within the eye of honor be assured. That means if you want to pay back the money in a very honorable way, in a legal way, without borrowing and stealing and all that, then my purse, my person, my extremist means, that means all my resources, whatever money I have, lie all unlocked to your occasions. I will obviously help you. I'll obviously help you with my money, with my person means. If I myself can do something, if my money can help you, I will give you all kinds of help. I support you in every way possible. Antonio is a very dear friend of Bassanio. Now Bassanio, in my school days, when I had lost one shaft, shaft means arrow. This one is a very important part. You have to be very careful. Questions come from this part, okay? In my school days, that means when I was a small boy and I used to, you know, shoot arrows, okay? Have the bow and arrow and I used to shoot arrows. And one, I had lost one shaft when I was playing with it. And I was practicing shooting arrows and I had lost one arrow because I shot in a wrong direction and it went into the forest and I cannot find the arrow anymore. I shot his fellow. Fellow means I shot another arrow on the self same flight. That means in the same direction and the self same way with the same force. I shot another arrow. Why? With more advice to watch. That means I watched carefully which way the second arrow is going. By watching it carefully, what would happen? I knew that where the first arrow can be, isn't it? Now, to find the other fourth, so if I shot another arrow in the same direction with the same force, then it might go and fall just beside the first arrow. And that way, to find the other fourth, in that manner, I often found both the arrows together. And by adventuring both, I often found both. When I went to find the second arrow, I also found the first one. How? Because I shot it with the same force in the same direction. So it would fall in the same place. Okay, this is an image which shows the small boy who is shooting the arrow. And this arrow, first time he might have been careless and he might have shot the arrow and it had gone somewhere else. But the second arrow, when he shot it with the same force and same direction so that it fell in the same place. He watched it carefully and often he found both the arrows. Okay, this part is very important. Okay, questions come from this part. I urge this childhood proof. Now, why is he talking about his childhood days? Because this is a proof. What follows is pure innocence. I owe you much. I have to pay back a lot of money to you. I have borrowed a lot of money from you. And like a willful youth means I have always spent here and there and here and there and have wasted your money. That which I owe is lost. What I had to pay you back, I have already lost the money. I have no money to pay you back. So the first amount of money that he had borrowed from Antonio is already spent and he cannot even pay that back to Antonio now. So he has a plan to pay it back. What is the plan? If you please to shoot another arrow that self same way which you did shoot the first, which means if like this small boy, if you shoot another arrow in the same direction, that means if you shoot another arrow means if you again give the same amount of money to me, shoot the arrow, give the same amount of money to me in the same direction means towards me. If you give the same money to me again, then what will happen? I would be careful. And because I would be careful, as I will watch the aim, I'll be carefully watching it now. I will not be spendthrift again to find both. Then what will happen? Because I would be careful this time, I would not lose your money and I can also then pay back the first loan and also the second loan together. Clear? Or bring your latter hazard. Latter hazard means second loan. I can obviously clear your second loan back again and thankfully rest data for the first. And at least I will have the first debt to pay you back. And it would be easier for me to pay back both the debts. Antonio, you know me well and herein spend but time. That means he says that, see, you know me very well. You are my very dear friend. And herein spend but time. You are wasting your time to wind about my love with circumstance. Why are you speaking so much? I don't think so much to help you. If you want another amount of money, tell me, I'll surely give it to you. And out of doubt, you do me now more wrong. So you are doubting that I may not give you the money. This is wrong. Obviously, a friend will help a friend. So you can obviously ask for more money from me. In making questions of my uttermost, that if you had made waste of all I have, then do but say to me what I should do. He says that even if you want to spend all my money, I have no problem. I can give you whatever you want. Just tell me. Then do but say to me what I should do. Tell me what I have to do for you, that in your knowledge may by me be done. Tell me whichever way I can help you, I will help you with that. And I am pressed. Pressed means I am ready to help. Undo it, therefore speak. Tell me how I can help you, I'll surely help you in that way. Bassanio says, in Belmont, now Bassanio says that what is the reason, why he requires money, who is the lady, what for the money is needed from Antonio. In Belmont, that means where is this lady living in? The lady lives in Belmont, which is a little bit far away from Venice. So he has to go to Belmont to meet the lady. For traveling, they needed to have ships, isn't it? To travel, and that needed to be a luxurious ship so that he can easily win the heart of Portia. He's so grandly coming into Belmont, isn't it? That is why he requires a lot of money. A lady is richly left. That means that lady's father has died and there was no more heir other than that lady. So she has inherited a lot of wealth after her father's death. She is fair. That means she is beautiful. Fairer than the word. So normally the word beautiful, she exceeds that word also. Okay, she is very, very beautiful. And other than being beautiful, of wondrous virtues, that means she is also very virtuous. She is a very good lady. Sometimes from her eyes, I did receive fair speechless messages. So when I met her once or twice, I felt, that means Bassanio felt, that Portia, that lady, had some feelings for Bassanio. Speechless messages. She did not come and directly tell Bassanio, see, I love you. But she gave some signals that, okay, I have some feelings for you. Her name is Portia. Now he says that the lady's name is Portia. Nothing undervalued to Cato's daughter Brutus's Portia. This is another reference compared to Portia in Julius Caesar. Spelling is wrong over here. Who was the daughter of Cato. So Bassanio relates this Portia to Brutus's Portia. That means Brutus's wife's Portia who was there in Julius Caesar. Okay. She is as good as her. Nor is the wide world ignorant of her worth. Wide world means all across the world, from every place in the world, people are coming with an intention to marry her. Okay, so people from various parts of the world, they have already come to know about her beauty, about her wealth, about her virtues. Okay, for the four winds blow in from every coast. So four winds blow in from every coast means from everywhere in the world. From every coast, people are coming in, traveling in ships to Belmont to meet this lady as her renowned suitor. Suitor means those who come with an intention or with a hope to marry somebody. And her sunny locks, that means Portia's sunny locks. Sunny locks means the bright golden hair of Portia, hang on her temples like a golden fleece. Her hair is compared to the golden fleece. I'll tell you a story over here. What do you mean by fleece? Fleece means the wool of a sheep. Okay, the wool. They have wool on their body, you know. So that is called the fleece. Now there was a very strange story. The story is all about, the reference is of a Greek legion. There was a legion, mythological story, where we come to know that there was a sheep which had golden colored fleece, golden colored hair. Okay. This had magical powers of healing. That means they could cure any disease. This wool on this golden wool on the sheep could cure any kind of diseases. It had a magical power. Okay. So her hair, that means Portia's hair, is compared to the bright golden color wool of this magical sheep. Okay. Which makes her seat of Belmont's Colchis strand. So he says that it is quite similar to the ancient kingdom of Colchis, where all the adventurous people went, because this sheep could be found where? in Colchis. Colchis is a particular place, a kingdom, where this sheep was tied to an oak tree. Okay, the sheep was tied by a local king. It was tied to an oak tree so that it could not run away. And people from different parts of the world knew about the magical power of this sheep and came from different places. Just like her suitors, just like Portia's suitors are coming from different places to marry her. Just like this magical sheep, which is very, have a lot of qualities, Portia also have a lot of qualities. And just like people came to take this, to win this sheep, people from different parts of the world are coming to meet Portia because of her qualities. Now, which makes her, okay, and many Jasons. Who is a Jason? Jason is the hero of the story of this Greek legend. The hero, why is he the hero? Because he is the one who finally won this golden fleece. See the story now. Jason, a hero, went on the dangerous voyage on a ship to Colchis. I already told you where was the sheep present. This magical sheep was present in Colchis. He went to Colchis on a ship in a dangerous voyage. And where is this place? It is in the east coast of Black Sea in search of this golden wool. He went in search of this golden magical wool. Where was it? It was tied to the oak tree, I already told you, by a local jeweler in Colchis. It was present in Colchis. This fleece had magical healing power, I told you. This wool had qualities of curing any kind of disease. It was guarded by whom? By a dragon. And Jason defeated the dragon and finally won the golden magical fleece. So, he wants to be, who wants to be like Jason? Bassanio wants to be like Jason. He wants to win Portia, just like Jason won the golden fleece. Clear? Next. Oh my Antonio, had I but the means, that means if I had money to hold a rival place with one of them, I also want to be like the adventurous heroes who went to win the magical fleece. I also want to be a suitor of Portia. I also want to go to Belmont. But what do I lack? I have a mind presages me such thrift that I should question less be fortunate. I am very much aware, I am very much sure that I would be fortunate. I would be able to marry Portia, but you know, I don't have the money. Antonio, thou knowest that all my fortunes are at sea. Now Antonio is rich, but all his money is invested in his ships. The ships have to come back and then he would profit and then he would have a lot of money. But now, for the time being, his money is invested in those ships. So he does not have cash in hand. Neither have I money nor commodities. So I don't have enough money to give you to raise the present sum. Therefore, go forth. So what you can do is you go use my credit. See, Antonio is a very famous businessman. So if Bassanio goes and asks for money, nobody will give him. But if he asks the money on behalf of Antonio, now Antonio has a goodwill. People will give money on Antonio's sake, on behalf of, for the sake of Antonio. That shall be racked. So that can be stretched. Now people can surely give you money if they hear that you want the money for Antonio. Okay. Antonio has a goodwill in the market. He is a very well-established businessman. Even to the uttermost, to furnish thee to Belmont, to fair Portia. So if you ask for money on for the sake of me, for the sake of Antonio, then people will give you the money and you can surely go to meet Portia. Go presently inquire. So go immediately, ask for the money, and so will I. I will also go and arrange for the money. Where money is, and I no question make to have it of my trust or for my sake. So I'm sure that I'll be able to raise that amount of money so that you can go to Belmont to meet Portia. So he is, that means Antonio is quite sure that by using his goodwill or the business credit, he has a market value also. So he can easily raise the money which is required. So that is all. From here we come to know that the main part of the story, one of the main parts of the story, that Bassanio has to go to Belmont to marry Portia. Portia is another important character in this story. So we get an introduction to the main characters. Okay. Now the characters exit. Antonio is also an important part, important character of the story. I hope I have made this part clear to all of you. If you have any questions from the workbook, you know, Xavier Pinto is an important workbook which you can easily follow. If you find any question that you cannot answer, if you cannot frame, you can obviously write it in the comment section. I will be happy to help you. Thank you so much. If you have liked my video, please comment, subscribe and share.